folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on listing objects on MinIO using our Java client API. And in this video, we're going to be working with OpenJDK19 and Maven 4. Maven's going to control our dependencies and build our packages. And then we're going to be connecting out to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can connect to and work with the MinIO platform. And we're going to be running all of this out of Visual Studio Code. And just to dive into our agenda a little bit, we're going to be working with the list objects method. And this method takes a list objects args object. And list object args has a bunch of different ways that you can configure how your list objects methods call is going to work. In particular, you can work with recursion, you can get versioning information. There's tons of different arguments that you can hand to this. I will show you a few of them when we get into our code. Speaking of which, let's go ahead and look at that. So here we have our app class, which has a simple main method. The main method is really just connecting out to play.min.io and giving me this MinIO client connection and handling any exceptions so that we can focus on some good code here. Here in the demo method, we are connecting out to the bucket named Java demo bucket, and that makes it very simple to build this list objects arg here on line 36. All I need to do is hand it that bucket name and then build it. And this allows us to call the list objects method on line 40 here and get an iterable response. Now, this is very strongly typed to results and items. Results and items are both objects that are part of the MinIO client library, and each one of those allows me to get some information or an exception coming out of my list objects call. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to iterate over that whole list of results. And in each result, I'm going to grab the item, as you can see here. And then I'm going to print out my object name and the size of the object, just to show you that we can get some additional information about each item. So let's go ahead and run this. We'll go ahead and build this right now, Maven clean and package. And then we're going to go ahead and run it as well with Java jar target demo, because we've got an executable jar. And there we go. Up on the Java demo bucket in play.min.io right now, we have two objects. We've got a hello world text, relatively small, and we've got a slightly larger image PNG. And that allows us to show you really what we've got here. So I can get some different information back out. If I didn't want to get the size, I could get something different, like perhaps e-tags. I can get information about the version ID if I have it. I can get information on whether or not it has been deleted, when it was last modified. Lots of different information that I can get about this particular item on my server. So let's do a version ID. And of course, to get the version ID, I'm actually going to need to make a slight change to my list object args as well. I need to include versions. And when I include the versions with a true, this will actually give me each and every version that's out there. Also, this is a very flat call. So if I actually want to do a recursive call, I need to include this recursive true as well. Now, there's a lot of other method calls that you can run on this. You can get information about extra headers. You can run queries. You can get user metadata, should you want to do that. You can get all kinds of additional information. You can even use a particular prefix if there's only one prefix that you want to delve into. There's also the ability to use API version 1, and this is because Amazon S3, which we are up to date with, has both a version 1 and a version 2 of how you do a list object. Version 2 is much more performant, so that's the one you're going to use mostly. So let's just go ahead and do a recursive version included call to this. And we'll go ahead and save this, and we're going to rebuild, and then we will rerun it as well. And I'm going to go ahead and, when I run this, because there's a lot of versions, Java jar target is demo. And we're going to go ahead and increase the size of this because we've got a lot of versions out there. There we go. So I've got a bunch of different versions available to me here. So I've got a lot of versions of Hello World text. I've got a lot of versions of the image out there. But even with recursion, that's all I've got. I've got Hello World and I've got this image. That's it. That's all that's in the bucket. So that is our demonstration on how to list objects in a MinIO bucket using Java. I hope you've enjoyed this little demo. If you'd like to reach out to us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also reach out to us interactively on Slack at minio.slack.com, or you can just leave a comment here on this video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.